I'm here today with Sarah Hopping Estrella, who's a CrossFit Level 3 trainer. She also holds a master's in nutrition and human performance, and we're gonna be talking about oils. So we know that fats in general and oils are an important part of our diet. They're important for things like vitamin absorption, brain function, nerve function. And so we wanna make sure that we're incorporating healthy oils into our diet, but there are a lot of options out there. So how do I distinguish between an oil that might be healthy or good for me and an oil that I might want to avoid?
Sure. The main difference is the degree of processing in these oils. So some oils like sunflower oil, canola oil require a pretty high degree of processing, and that processing removes the natural nutrients from the oil, can lead to some oxidation, and that isn't very good for you.
Mm-hmm. And those oils tend to be a lot more pro-inflammatory, and we tend to see then people who consume a lot of those processed oils to have some degree of chronic inflammation. And chronic inflammation is associated with a variety of chronic diseases, things like cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, cancer, arthritis, a whole host of other ones. So we wanna really try to avoid those highly processed oils and focus on others that are gonna be minimally processed and more nutrient dense. So what are those oils that I should be focusing on?
Yeah, so better choices of oils tend to be avocado oil, coconut oil, olive oil. Mm-hmm. Grass-fed butter isn't an oil, but could be a good choice as well, depending mm-hmm. on the application.
Awesome. So if I focus on those and I avoid things like vegetable oils and canola oils, I'm going to be in a pretty good place. Is there anything else that I should take into consideration when I'm using those oils in my diet?
Sure. There's something called smoke point, which is where the oil gets heated to a point that it starts to burn. Mm-hmm. Oils have different smoke points. And so when you're cooking, things that have the lower smoke points aren't the best choice. Olive oil is an example of that. Mm-hmm. So keeping in mind the smoke point, how hot you intend to cook, choosing things like butter, avocado oil for cooking, and reserving oils like olive oil for salad dressing is usually a better choice.
Awesome. And that's what I tend to do, is just keep my avocado oil right by the stove if I'm cooking. And then if I'm going to be making a salad, I'll use my olive oil. So yep. Great tip. So in general, there are a lot of different types of oils out there, but we want to focus on those that are going to be more minimally processed. So things like olive oil, avocado oil, coconut oil, grass-fed butter, and avoid those processed vegetable oils and canola oils. And then if we're cooking, we might want to use something with a higher smoke point like avocado oil. Otherwise, we can go crazy with all those other healthy oils. So yep. Thanks so much, Sarah.
Yeah.